Greg Anton is a close friend I've known for close to 20 years, and 30 years he's brought marketing expertise to some of the biggest countries, countries and companies in the country.
Good stuff.
He has worked with Bristol Myers Squibb, Novartis, heard of Microsoft, Apple,
A little bit,
Nike, Intel.
Mm-hmm. Those are whoppers.
Yeah. So and he has worked with all of them, and he's the only he's the person you've heard me say on this program. I just said it last week.
What?
He's the one who said new media is all media.
Yeah.
Because I said to him several years ago, what do I need a website for? I got a TV show. What do I need social media for? I got a radio program.
That's true.
So here's my question. In the next 6 years, 75% of our employees and 75% of our customers are going to be the M word. Ready for this?
What is this?
Millennial.
Oh, I love those people. Yeah.
Now,
love you.
Now, you
help
better
me.
Get ready because they represent one of the biggest wealth class, intergenerational wealth class shifts in the country. Greg, I got to believe that marketing, first of all, I know media consumption's changed. You own a couple millennials, as I do, and as Russ does too. How does that change your world? Because this, I mean, even in the last 5 years,
right.
I'm not talking like 10 years, I'm talking the last couple years even.
No, what's amazing is millennials now watch 45% less traditional TV than they used to, right? So they're not even turning on the box.
So does that, okay, just micro, in 20 years, does that mean the television advertising model is probably shifted elsewhere?
It's already shifted.
No kidding.
Yeah.
The king today is video. People used to say content is king, but video content is king.
Hello.
And the reason video content is king is everyone is watching every video that's posted at a rate that's astronomical. 258% increase in YouTube video consumption.
Put it up and they will come.
Yeah. And you know, click-through rates, not to get too technical with marketing terms, but are increased something like 60% if you watch a video versus just reading a text page.
Oh my God, yes.
Something like that. So
well, with so with respect to that, they're driving that, though, are they not?
The millennials?
Yeah.
They absolutely are. They want to get immersed into a brand, and they want a relationship with a brand.
Yeah.
And it's this whole theory of transitioning your brand from aspirational to lifestyle brand.
Mm-hmm.
And lifestyle brands, they like say, buy me. They're not aspirational where people are thinking, oh, someday I might be able to own that.
Right.
They create this sense that I want this today.
Now.
It defines me.
And it can probably get there today, too.
And they do. And nothing will stop them from buying it.
Well, and the interesting part of this thing is this year, they say $24 trillion, 1.5 times the whole U.S. economy.
Dollars.
Is going to be, that's the wealth of the global millennial.
Mm. Right.
So, listen, and I always say, look, you realize that when we're Grays on Trays, they're going to be running this place.
That's next year for me.
Yeah. I mean, look at and the main reason that millennials already can arguably control significant levels of wealth is because of the boomers are transferring their wealth. I mean,
yeah,
it's as simple as that. The other piece of it, though, there's a really big disparity between the haves and the have-nots with the millennials.
Gap.
Half of the wealth is owned by the 1%. Does that sound familiar?
Yeah,
that is just how free market economies work, but that's how it is. So if you think in terms of the spending power and the fact that the income's clustered at the top, when you're faced with anything from healthcare marketing to B2B and to B2C, how are you having to shift, and how do you even negotiate the change when you're dealing with guys in the boardroom that are our age?
Right.
That's got to be a tough one, right?
Well, you just kind of have to take them by the lapels and say, look, what you used to do doesn't work, and don't do it. And if you want to do that, I'm not the guy for you. Go find someone else.
Yeah.
You know, we're looking for companies that want to disrupt, want to innovate, do not want to do it traditionally, because none of that stuff is really breaking through right now.
No.
Right.
You know, you talked about that that theory we developed a few years ago.
New media is all media.
New media is all media.
Right.
Well, that's evolved. And the answer to your question is, it's new media is all media all day.
Right.
The frequency of your messaging is the key.
Yeah. And
all
when
media
it comes
all day.
It's no longer like, oh, someone might be watching this after dinner. Hell no, they're watching at 2 a.m.
You know, they used to say that your message or your ad had to be viewed 7 times before it broke through or had any impact.
Right.
Heck, you can do that in 7 minutes now, right? How long did it used to take you to get 7 times impression? But now you can do it so quickly.
Okay, so here's my question. You explained, and I want you to do this again so eloquently. We'll do this in the next break here. But you explained so eloquently that that the difference between branding, marketing, and advertising, and there is a difference, and I don't think Russ could tell us.
I don't have to.
But I believe because guess. brand is the umbrella.
Okay.
So Greg Anton, CEO of Greg Anton Marketing. GregAnton.com. Look at that. BigBizShow.com. Give us a second.
Focus.
Ponder on that.
Focus.
Marinate on what we just gave you.
Wow, Bob.
Russ and Sully back in a second.
Hey,
Greg Anton, CEO of Greg Anton Marketing. GregAnton.com is our marketing expert here. And he's worked with everyone from Nike to Intel to Bristol-Myers Squibb to Novartis. The guy that really invented the line, new media is all media, meaning that you're leaving money on the table if you don't take advantage of every single thing that's out there marketing-wise. So we were talking about sort of the millennial opportunity and that customer experience being so different. But at the same time, we're following right along. I mean, it's not just millennials that are driving this thing, because look at Russ wakes up in the morning, the first thing he does is take a selfie and post it up there and
of course, hoping for then open a beer.
That's right.
Hoping for some. But the point, we're also consuming media the same way.
You know, it's you think about everyone's trying to pivot towards millennials, but you just have to follow the proper marketing channels that are effective today. And we talked about some of them previously, but people are consuming content online, mobile, not traditional TV, sorry, but not traditional radio. And if you're on those channels, you really have to be disruptive and innovative.
So talk about the branding, marketing, and advertising thing that we went to before the break. Mm-hmm. Branding is the umbrella? Is that how that works? Is the brand the umbrella? Is the advertisement the umbrella? Is that, how does all these things work together?
So
what's the difference between that?
Branding is the personality of your company, of your product. It is really who you are, and it's how you build a relationship with your customers.
Got it.
And your clients, and it's who you are. It's that personal connection, and that's the key to marketing today, is building a personal connection.
Sure.
And one of the keys to do that is to put relevant content and make that available.
So but that content has to match your personality / brand, though, doesn't it?
It does.
Because I see that big mistake all the time, where you see brands, and all of a sudden, there's a disconnect there.
Look at my website, and I put these quotes from marketing thought leaders on there, and Richard Branson had a great one that basically said, brands try to be something they're not. And then when you experience a brand, there's such a disconnect that it's not authentic. And people leave. They walk away.
Right.
Yeah, authenticity is a big deal with all of us now, because we've turned into skeptical buyers because we have instant BS detectors right in our hands 9 times out of 10.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, what's one of the first things you do? You look at reviews.
That's exactly right.
When you're looking to buy a product. And then you look at videos. And then you might look at, ask people about it word of mouth.
And we're getting to the point where we're reviewing the reviewers, too.
That's right.
I mean, we're getting skeptical.
Oh, yeah,
what is this guy?
Wait a minute.
Right. I mean, honestly, we're getting sophisticated as buyers. That's got to make your job harder, and it's got to make the marketing department
harder. Well, us marketers are right up or down there with politicians and everyone else these days, because, you know, can I trust this? Well, that's where the brand has to speak for itself.
Right.
And that's where that authentic personality needs to come out. So there's a close connected relationship.
So then what is the difference after you have that personality / brand between marketing and advertising?
Right. Advertising are just the tactics that you communicate with.
Okay.
And,
mm-hmm.
you know, if through
billboard, magazine ads on your website.
How old is he?
I know. Well, okay, that's I was going to ask you.
I thought I'd pull out some old ones.
We can't even spell billboard anymore.
Yeah. Is it two words, Bill?
I mean, the only time you pick up a magazine is when you're in a waiting room these days, honestly.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I mean, is that going to be a dead art, or is that just all these magazines and periodicals are online and they just happen to print one too? Is that
it? Just saves you from printing out.
That's right. Here's the strategy, though. You need to, you know, all media all day, also every way. You need to connect with your customers how they want to be connected with. Some buyers want to open a magazine and read it, so you have to have a presence there. That was the theory behind.
So if you're
the font is getting bigger on those.
So if you're selling electric wheelchairs to my mom and dad, I'm not kidding. That's going to be a different advertising than if you're selling cannabis to Russ, for example.
So direct mail still converts, but only for a small segment. And the really key to marketing today is segmenting your audience and knowing which segments want to be communicated with in what way, and then providing that.
And sometimes that's done automatically from just a click through a website, and boom, we know who this is, what they like, when they went to sleep last night.
Well, on that subject, Russ brought up two good points today, which is a freaking record.
I'm done.
So my point is if you know, there's this traffic and conversion thing that happens online. I mean, the traffic and conversion is, and Russ is just a sucker for this. This is, I mean, when you see, here's Russ, picks up a phone, looks just like this. Bam! Immediately you click on, I mean, you have more crap that, I mean, you're buying waste baskets that fit on the counter.
They're so nice.
You're buying the thing that goes in between the seat that catches your sunflower
seeds. The love cup, yes.
You're catching the cell phone cup thing. Every one of those things
those
you bought,
are
Nina.
The best. Have you had one
you
yet?
Bought from a Facebook ad. That you get is... suckered in like the blue screen with the Visa on it,
well,
back
fine
in 1983.
With me.
You bet. There
right?
you go.
It so, saves me the trouble of, you know, looking for stuff I need.
So this traffic and conversion model works. Is that going to happen with Apple and Microsoft, or is it already happening?
Well, now there's many ways to block that. So, so if you don't want it fed to you, you can stop it.
I love
consumers
it.
Are being more educated on that.
Yeah.
But it works.
So how are advertisers gaming the system now? I mean, how are they getting to us?
Frequency.
Oh, no
They're
kidding.
They're everywhere.
Just yeah, they are.
Fire hose.
Yeah. I mean, that's it. Instagram ads are converting like crazy because of how much time people spend
on
Instagram.
That, you know that you have, you can boost an Instagram post.
There you go.
But you can also create an advertisement that go, it's called a dark story.
What?
And what it means is when you're looking at stories on Instagram or Facebook, you'll see an ad that comes up. Normally yours say the word testosterone on it.
Right, I need a little.
Or hair loss. Or something like that. You know, something like that. But I mean, but they're targeted, correct?
Right.
I mean, you're not getting one for, you know,
first of all,
bikinis.
I'm growing plenty of hair. It's just not coming out where I want.
So
but no, he's been segmented.
Yeah.
Because of his online history.
Yeah.
You're in a box.
Yeah.
And
like Birdwell Beach britches. Every day. I accidentally clicked. Not accidentally. I love
Birdwell
Beach.
Because they invented them in 1972.
And I get ads for cool
stuff.
When
you turn 20.
And I click over there.
But you know, it's convenience.
It is.
When you want something, it's going to be there. And you don't have to go search.
Very quickly, we're almost out of time.
Good.
This time. We'll have Greg back a ton. But does that make your life easier or harder? The fact that they can, that the online stuff.
Data is driving marketing right now. We have so much data on consumers, and we can target the messaging, and it works.
I'm glad I could help.
That's why I started this agency, GregAntone.com, because we need to get the word out and use these tactics to help marketers.
GregAntone.com.
And hear ye on the corner just doesn't work anymore, huh?
Well, he's doing the hear ye. He's just not doing it where you think he's doing.
Hey, now.
Hear ye, all media, all day.
There it is. New media is all media all day, right? GregAntone.com is his website.